How to create this text photo in Adobe Creative Cloud Express. Coming right up. Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm talking about creating these text photos using Adobe Creative Cloud Express. I'm going to walk you through how to create these using the mobile versions iOS and Android side-by-side comparison. So if you use either of those two platforms, you'll be able to create these. We're looking here at the iOS and Android versions of Adobe Creative Cloud Express. If you've not downloaded, go do that now and then come back and follow along with this video. First off, we're going to click on the plus sign to start a project. Now on the iOS version, it looks a little bit different where you start from or where you choose your image. And on the Android, you can see it's a bit different. We're going to click on the gallery in the Android, and on the iOS version, we're going to go to photo library. And I've got the same picture for both. So we're going to bring that picture into the project here to work on. So the next step here is to choose the size, and I'm going to go with the Instagram square. That works just fine, or you can go with Instagram portrait. It just depends on what your preference is. I'm going to go with the square version and then tap on done for both of those. And as you can see, I already have some text available, and I'm going to make a minor adjustment here on my iOS version. I'm going to bring down that photo here. Let's just see if I can make further adjustment. Let's click on adjustment and scale it. Okay, so it is already scaled perfectly. All right, so now the next step here is we're going to add some text for this I am text photo. So these are adjectives to describe who you are. I'm going to type in some adjectives to describe who I am, and then I'll be right back. Here are my adjectives, or the words that I'm going to use to describe myself. Now, one tip as you create this is when you enter one word, you hit return so that you can go to the next line. That's just one of the tips. It'll make this project work great. So make sure you do that. And I'll click done on the iOS and hit the check mark. And there we have the words. Doesn't matter that it looks like that, a little bit different, that's fine. And now what we're going to do is go over to your align option, and we are going to right align the text. We want the text to be on the right hand side, because that's going to make this work just fine. And then what we're going to do is create an effect. We're going to choose the effect, and as you can see, it already has a shape, but we want to edit that shape, and we want to choose a square. We want the square option because that'll cover up most of what's there. And then we're going to click on done, and what we want to do is go over to size, and then what we're going to do is go over to spacing, and we're going to adjust the spacing of the shape. We want to give that shape just a little bit more, not too much, but just enough. And then what we can do is bring the line down for your text just a tad bit. Now we'll click on done, and then what I'll do is manually adjust the text. I'm going to manually adjust it right about there, and I'm going to move this one right about there. Let's cover up kind of the center of my face there. And now what I'll do is go over to color. And what I want to do is for the shape, I want the shape to be very contrasty. And I like white because that just looks great. Makes it really stand out and pop. And then we'll tap on done and go over and choose a font. Now this is where in your text photo will stand out. You want to choose a font that's kind of thick, I would say. Like over here on this side, it's got the Next Rust. Let's see, let's try Source. That one looks good on there. Let's try that one, a little bit different. And if it changes, if it gets a little too close, then you could always adjust the spacing. Let's see what this one looks like. Let's try that one. I think I'll use that one over here on the left, and we'll use that one on the right. So we'll tap on done. So now the next thing we'll do is go tap on our shape here, and we're going to go to the effect. Let's come back over here. We'll go to effect. And what you'll want to do is choose mask the text. And what happens is it basically breaks the text through, so it'll see your photo in the back. The next thing we'll do is we're going to add some shapes by going to the icon option, and we're going to choose square, or actually let's go rectangle. and we're going to import some rectangles. Choose a rectangle and we're going to add that one in. And it doesn't matter that it's a different color, that's fine. And we're going to adjust that rectangle and move it so it matches your text over there. Again, you wanna make sure it lines up. Make it larger so it covers. And we'll go ahead and change the color to white. So that way it matches your white text box there. And if you need to, you could always go to adjust and do a little fine tuning. There we go. I think this one is okay. Maybe bring it down some. And now the next thing we'll do is duplicate that shape and we'll just place it in the other spots where we need to cover up our photo. So here we got the edit option, duplicate, duplicate. We're gonna do that twice. So we got one shape here for the bottom. And over here, we're gonna bring the other shape, and just for good measure, let's flip this one around here. And we're just gonna bring that one so that it just covers up any space that may be showing up over there on the left-hand side. We just wanna make sure and cover it up. It doesn't matter if it overlaps because I can't seem to get this one. There we go. It doesn't matter if the shape goes off the screen because when you export it, it'll cut it off. It'll crop that. So here we go. Let's tap on done and done. Now we'll just check the photo. We'll do a little fine adjustment here on this Android one. Let's make sure. There we go. Perfect. Now, if you do see some bleeding in between, all you need to do is just adjust your shape so that it covers up. But I think for the most part, we've got this here. We're ready to go. And then the next thing you'll do is just hit the share button and you can save the image to your libraries and then share this on social media. And that's how you can create your own IM text photo using Adobe Creative Cloud Express on your phone. Let me know what you thought about this video. If you have any comments or questions, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit the like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with others. Thank you once again for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.